We're here at Craig Cameron's ranch, and I'm Amy Wilson from RFD TV and the Cowboy Channel. Really excited to have the opportunity to work with both Craig and Charmayne James. I brought a couple horses. The first we're going to work with is a bay horse. He's about 10 years old. I've only had him a couple months. I bought him because breakaway roping is exploding and I want to be out there roping. And he has a couple issues that I want to work through, mainly building his confidence and getting his trust. The story I get is that he was maybe beat on a little bit before, and I can just tell in the box when the pressure's on, he panics just a little bit, and I want to mostly get him over that.
Well, I think, you know, maybe we should just back him up to some foundation work and try to rebuild and regain that confidence. So again, I always say from good beginnings, things tend to come naturally.
Yeah, definitely a confidence builder, and you're at the right place for that.
That's for sure.
Well, we'll see. And you know, it's funny because when I saw you walking him up here, and as we walked up, I heard him snorting and stuff. So he is a little watchy out there.
Yeah, he definitely is. You'll hear him.
Well, I'm going to come in here and get this horse's attention and start earning a little respect. I'm just going to kind of wait on this horse. I'm not going to try to make anything happen. Just set it up and let him find it. But you can see Charmayne, he's kind of blowing and snorting and a little unsure.
Yeah, for sure.
Ooh. Ooh. I don't want him to think I'm out to get him. I'm just out to work with him and not against him. Off we go again. He acts like he's a little one-sided. He prefers that left. I'm gonna try to draw him to me. Right there. See how he favors that left eye. Good. I want him to know that even though I'm moving a little fast, that I'm not gonna hurt him. But like all horses, by nature, they don't like loud noises. They don't like fast movements, but our world's full of them. And I want him to see that he can accept them and figure out that I'm not gonna hurt him. All right, I'm gonna go to the halter. Just that quick, I'm gonna go to the halter because this horse is being ridden and it isn't like he's never been rode before. So I'm just starting out easy, showing him I'm the leader. He's going to be the follower, not through pain, not through fear, just through the work. So I'm going to kind of approach him nice and easy with my halter here. See, and my job is going to be what? To make him feel safe, sure, certain, and secure, because that's what he's not. That's what Amy was saying. He's really unsure. And if somebody got after this horse and whipped him around, again, all you get out of that is self-preservation. Boy, that's tough when they're just working through straight self-preservation. They're tough then. So I got me a good halter and lead. I can start just by throwing it up on his back, around his feet, and he's pretty good about it right now. Here, everything I do, I'm gonna try to work both sides of this pony. And there's that deal we were talking about, where he's more sure on that left eye than he is the right. So on this horse, I may have to do a lot more on the right because again, he's a little bit one-sided. So I'm gonna see if I can start him out on this side. Start him out. And she told me she's really hadn't lunged this horse. Step up, step up, step up. Good. And just get that controlled forward movement. You can see I'm swinging that rope in his eye. I can reach up and touch him with that rope. And watch, I'm gonna prepare him by disengaging that hip. I'm gonna draw that to me. Good, right there. And he's gotta get used to those fast movements. And right now, maybe really important that I just stop for a second. Let him kind of think about what's going on. Let him figure out that, hey, we're not out to get him. And the more that I put my hands on this horse, touch him, rub him, let him know that I'm gonna be a friend to him, the better he's gonna be. So I think rubbing and petting these horses is pretty important to them.
Oh, yeah, for sure. They gotta get that trust, and that's everything.
I think it is everything. You know, without the trust, and for me, from the horse's point of view, and I keep trying to work from the horse's point of view, trust is a belief that we'd never do anything to hurt him. So these little resting spots become really important. So I'm gonna start the other direction now, and I'm gonna start soft. If I needs more energy to get him to move, as soon as he moves off, I'm putting some softness in there. But I wanna keep those feet moving, because just like in the barrel race, breakaway roping, it's all gonna be about controlled forward movement. So we don't want these horses afraid or scared. So I'm gonna get to where I can send him, send him, send him. There, that's better. And you can see I got a nice loose rein here. Step him up. See, I can kind of get after him a little bit right there. And watch me prepare him to bring him to me. I'm gonna start bringing him to me, and I'm gonna push that hip around, boom, and let that horse come to me. Where I am is gonna be the sweet spot. It's gonna be the soft spot. I'm gonna try to fix it up where wherever I am, that's where he's gonna wanna be, because that's gonna be the best spot to be. So I'm gonna walk over on this right side. See how he turns his head? He says, I prefer you in that left eye. And they can really get one-sided, and I bet, you know,
but that happens maybe from just us being on that side a lot.
You know,
we need to work both sides.
Exactly. We catch them on the left. We bridle them on the left. We halt them on the left. We saddle them on the left. We get on the left, get off on the left. You watch most people, then when they get on, they ride off to the left and load them on the left. And you bet they'll get one-sided, and it's usually to the left. So I'm going to come in here and pet on this horse here. Pet on this horse. Good. And right here, I can start just kind of working him a little bit. Getting him used to some things, just touching him. The more I can touch him, the better. See, he wants to back up and avoid me. He's not doing anything wrong. He's doing what he thinks he's supposed to do. So I'm gonna help him. I like to see him go forward just a little bit. Just a little bit, good. Just a little bit, step up, step up, step up. There we go, good. Step up, good. Step up, and I throw that rope across his back. You can see how he's a little unsure about things. Here, he's really close to me, and I can take my rope, touch him up here on this off side, on this on side, from the off side here. And the more I do, just going back to what? To basics and fundamentals right here. Working with that mind that controls his body, his legs, and his feet. So if he isn't relaxed in his mind, guys, he's not gonna be relaxed in his body, his legs, or his feet. So, boy, this old pony, I can see how he might be a little spooky riding him.
Hey, Craig, how much is he reading you, what you're thinking and paying attention to you? I know we've talked about that a little bit, but
yeah,
your intentions and your thoughts of what you're doing are as important as any of what you're doing. Not just anybody can get out there and do what you're doing.
Well, you know, I do have a goal, but, you know, you're exactly right. I'm watching him, he's watching me. It's a mind working with a mind right here. And he's not so sure about exactly what it is that I want. So in the beginning, if I could just get him to figure out, hey, everything I do, I'm not going to hurt you. Then pretty soon he starts to let down mentally, which allows him to let down physically. And then pretty soon you get the two together. So taking my time with this horse, going back to the beginning is gonna be a big deal to him. So you know the old saying, Amy, if you know, usually the better a horse is on the ground, the better he's gonna be when you get up on his back. So I can take this rope and touch him around his legs, touch him around his heart girth here, let that rope just touch him all over. I can touch around those back feet like that. You can see he doesn't necessarily like it. And I can take this rope, I'm gonna catch it this time, and I'm gonna move away from those back feet. I'm gonna touch him up here, and you can see he gets a little unsure. I'm gonna touch him with those back feet, If he gets real spooked, I'll drop it. I'm just letting him get more sure all the way through. I'm gonna try to capture 1 foot now. Take my time. Right there, I got the 1 foot here. Let me come around so you can see what I'm doing. There, here. Now let him wear that because I want this horse to be relaxed and gentle wear everywhere, from the first whisker in his nose to the last hair in his tail. And I think that's gonna be important, you know. So I can touch him with the rope here, here. And then she said that sometimes they have trouble shoeing him. So I can just go back to picking that foot up a little bit, just a little bit. And I'm gonna give it back right here. You can see he gets worried. He gets worried. So I think it's really important now that I just give him a minute to think. See, look, that's where he softens up. His head goes down. He blinks those eyes. He wiggles his ears, and he moves his mouth.
And his eyes softer.
Yeah, good.
I mean, that's probably one of the first things anybody needs to watch is the eye on a horse.
You know what?
That tells you a lot.
I think you're so right on that. You know, and he's got a big soft eye. He wants to be soft, you know.
Right.
I think he's looking for a friend.
Well, he's pretty smart. He looks really smart, but he probably not going to take abuse. I mean, most, you know, he's just not one of those that's going to, I'm going to take it. He's going to fight. He's going to fight a little.
I think you're exactly. That's why he snorts. He's saying, hey, if you get tough with me, I'm going to get tough.
Right.
I think that's right. And has he ever done anything really bad with you or?
Not really. In the box, when the pressure's on, I tried rope on him at Cheyenne, and that's a unique start anyway, which I thought would be better
pretty long,
you don't hear the chutes bang. But when I saw that calf where I wanted and I asked him to go, I think he thought he was in trouble because he never heard the chutes and I was making him move. And he spun and then took off, and he is crazy fast. I mean, he caught up to that calf at Cheyenne, but I just want him to be really solid. You know, the start's everything in that event at a lot of places.
Yeah, he was doing that out of self-preservation. Yeah. He got unsure.
Yeah, I just want him to be confident and know he can trust me and I'm not going to hurt him, which is what you're showing him.
Well, you know, well, we always say confidence is something gained, you know.
Right.
You either gain it or you lose it. We're working hard just to start back at the beginning to gain that confidence. So here I'm going to work this side just a little bit here around those legs. And he looks softer, not that he couldn't get unsure in a heartbeat, but I'm going to catch that rope right here, touch him with it. And I'm going to watch when I do that back in those flanks here. I can bring his nose to me. Maybe jump up and down a little bit. I'm gonna throw that rope around those hocks and go to those back legs again. I'm gonna try to capture 1 foot one more time. Right there. I'm gonna come on around with it. Ooh, good. I can start touching him up. Touching him up. Touching him up. I can go to maybe picking that foot up and just set it back down. I can see what he'll do right here on this off side. And just kind of working with him, taking my time to see if he can make a turn to his left. And then just come off that field. And he's like, damn, what was that? So I just take my time right there by stopping, letting him think about what just happened. So that he can learn from it.
Right, let it process.
Exactly. I think taking your time, slowing things down between maneuvers to let them think about what happened, and that's when they learn, and to me, that's when they start gentling up.
Right.
And I think a good cow-person horse wants a gentle horse.
Like, that horse knows you're not gonna do anything to him. He already has figured it out. Like, don't you suppose, how many horses have you really got after? You know, you've schooled them.
Yeah.
But never hurt them.
You know, I think personally anything that hurts the horse is incorrect. You know, I think the wrong thing, just like Tom Dornish used to say, make the wrong thing difficult, the right thing easy. So a different way you could say that would be making the wrong thing work, the right thing rest or relief. So again, it's not about punishment. They don't relate good to punishment. Discipline is an art form. So we can discipline them, but we don't punish them. So if we have to use some firmness, if it doesn't end up with a learning and a positive effect, I don't think we did a good job. So I'm gonna work with my flag here, 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 here. Good. I'm not, you see, he's backing up from that deal, see? Whoa. And I wanna be careful, I'm not looking to get pawed or nothing. That doesn't mean I wouldn't. Here, and I'm just gonna start rubbing him with this. Here, and here, and here. Good boy. And let him figure out what? The same thing we've been saying. I ain't not gonna hurt you. But you know, he can accept that saddle, he can accept that pad. So I think he could learn to accept this little flag too. And it's just gonna help him. And if he needs to leave, I'm gonna let him leave. I wouldn't try to hold him, but I would turn it into work for him so that he'd figure out being here was the easy spot, the sweet spot, the good spot. Here, here. So I'm just kind of working easy. And remember, when you come on this side, you're working with that other eye. Just like on those barrels, you gotta go left, you gotta go right, you gotta have them balanced up.
Right.
Yeah. So I'm gonna come over here. And this is his tougher side here. I wouldn't try to discipline him for snorting and all that. He's just doing what he thinks he needs to do. So I certainly don't try to take that away from him. You know, pretty soon, by doing it with me, he's gonna figure out he doesn't need to do it. And that might take some time. So we're willing to give him the time here. So here, it's a little more. If he needs to move his feet, let him move. Good. Good. And Charmayne, that horse you brought me to work that time, Sea-Doo, he was a lot like this horse, I mean, and he was big and strong, and man, he was a little spooky.
Yeah, well, and he could buck too, you know.
Oh man, he was tough, yeah.
You did a good job on him.
Well, thank you, but he kind of reminds me of this horse. I mean, he wants to snort at you and be kind of warn you a little bit, and I'm listening. I'm dang sure listening, so here. Pretty good, pretty good. See, he thinks he has to leave. Just, if you need to leave, you just go right ahead. You just go right on.
You know, in some horses, it's just kind of their hereditary, like they get it from the mare, the mom is like it, they're all spooky, and then sometimes it's created by, you know, situation. It might have been that cracked tooth he had that started it, and they got after him, and...
I think that's a really good point. You know, we make a really big deal out of the sires, but I think the mama's really important, how she is, her bloodlines, her nature, because then she lives with the mama for 6 or 9 months or something, so she's gonna pick up a lot of mama traits, so
for
that
sure.
Is really correct.
Yes. Yeah, once you raise them, you kind of begin to figure out that they begin to act a lot like the mare and carry those same habits.
Exactly.
Since he didn't come with papers, I'm not sure on either side, obviously, but I will say tracking a calf around in the arena, he wants to sit down and cut one. So I don't know if there's some of that in his blood or if he's had some training or what, but he will watch a cow really good.
You know, I think that's really interesting. Amy's talking about this horse doesn't have any papers. And you know what? Papers are wonderful and a good thing, but shoot, they don't have to have papers to be a really good horse, but you bet I would say he looks cow bred.
Yeah.
And he probably does want to come to chase after a cow, and I like that.
And with him being a cow horse, that doesn't mean he can't run.
That's right.
You know, we'll be fast enough to go run barrels. You know, we can go get Seattle Slough off the track, he might not clock running barrels.
That's true, you just don't know.
You just don't know till you
actually get
out
there. Yeah, so a good cow horse doesn't mean he couldn't be a good barrel horse. All right, let's let him move again. He stood there a good while. I'm gonna move him now with the flag, so that's different. And he looks good. He's got his ears up. He doesn't look troubled. He's real balanced. He looks more balanced to me now. And you watch my lead line. I'm not pulling on him. Little guiding touches. Now watch me take my switch hands here so I can push that hip over. I'm gonna move over into this eye and send him this way. And that's so much better because Amy told me she never lunged this horse before. So we're working both eyes. Watch, I fix him and release him. Correct him, keep him right in here close. Touch him with that flag. Touch him where my legs are gonna go. Good. And I'm gonna bring in, watch, I've switched hands, but my flag is still over to my left and I can push that hip over. and I'll give him a little rest right there. So he's following a feel. We're controlling at this point pretty well the head, neck, got those shoulders looking good. He's nice and straight, driving from behind, and he looks more relaxed, and he's not snorting as much.
I think his disposition's changed a
lot.
Oh,
yeah. And okay, so when you get done there, you kind of turn away from him a little bit, like you're not looking at him. Do you feel like that it's like, hey, I'm not looking you down or coming after you. It's like it's just not
taking
intimidating.
Taking that pressure off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you can see.
And see how I got my back turned. That really takes a lot of pressure off of him, too. Real soft lead line at this point. Not asking for anything. But the sweet spot is here with me. So I'm trying to fix it up where wherever I am, pretty soon that's where he's going to want to be. So pretty soon I'm going to get it where if I walk this way, he's going to want to be with me. You know, I'm not pulling on him or anything. Good boy. Good boy. If I go this way, he's going to want to be with me. And because horses, as we all know, are herd animals. And they're going to pick up pretty quick whether you're leading or whether you're following. So you need to be a leader, not through pain, not through punishment, just through the work. You establish that leadership, and pretty soon here they come. All right, I want to try something different here. I was just going to bring a different piece of equipment in here just to get him more used to things, and I'm not forcing anything on this horse. If he couldn't tolerate it, shoot, I'd take it away and do it another day, you know. And again, you say, well, that's not much. Well, it isn't, but it looks different, it feels different. And with this, you know, I can get to where I can touch him all over here, and just run it. And I kind of put some pressure and go down his sides and kind of get him where he can accept things here. I'll put it between their legs like this and just touch him with it. He may have to move. See, and that's a blind spot for the horse. Right there, that's a blind spot. And be aware of those blind spots. If it troubled him bad enough, man, I wouldn't force it on him. I'd take it away. Yeah. We're not out to bother him. We're out to help him. So taking it away for a second, I'll bring it back soft. Here. Good boy. I'm not going to harm you. We better work that other side. Here. Good. There's that blind spot. Good. You're all right. Good boy. And there's a lot of different things I could do with this horse to get him better. Anything that'll get him better, shoot, I'm willing to give it a whirl.
I think horses like this too, that are kind of watchy and he's not dead feeling, like they usually can kind of come on and do something.
You know what? I think you're so right. And even though this horse doesn't have papers, I think somewhere he's got some pretty good blood in him. He seems to have a really good mind.
Have you done any of this with him, Amy?
You know, I get home from work and I either pony or try to rope before dark. And so I haven't spent a lot of time on the ground doing this. So he's really coming along fast, I think.
So again, I just use a different piece of it. And this one makes a little more noise, and she's roped off him. So he kind of knows a little bit about what a rope is, but I'm just kind of using it in a different way.
Yeah, some horses don't like that rope on them like that.
Well, they don't like that. But, you know, if a guy could do this every day before he rode, just a little bit, and you'd be surprised how fast it'll go once they get used to it. And pretty soon, they're just better and better and better. Like, there's different things. Like, I can take the rope, like on a horse, and put it all over him like this. This rope's longer. It's got that Honda on the end. Put it around his legs. There's so many different things you can do with them like that, like right here. And this horse might be pretty good because she ropes with him. So I'm gonna try to build a little loop and just kind of put it around his hocks right there. Right here. Just see what he does. Here. Like that. See, and he kind of doesn't think a whole lot of it, but I just want him to learn to wear it. I'm gonna watch me take the slack out and pick it up and take it out. Pick it up and take it out. And even though he's a rope horse, he doesn't like that. See his ears, and that troubles him. But I'm not forcing it. I pick it up, take it away. I pick it up, take it away. Pick it up. Woo. You're doing fine. You're doing good. I'm not in a hurry, you know. And so pretty soon he'll learn that it's not gonna hurt him. Everything's okay. That's better right there. Better. 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 Good. Better. That's so much better. Woo. Good boy. Good horse. Good horse. I'm gonna watch my rope here. Better. Better. See, and that honing makes some noise too. A lot better. Not gonna hurt you. Good boy. And you just get a little bit each day. That's about all you need. You don't need a whole lot. Just let him find a little change in there. Let him figure out it's not gonna hurt him. Shoot and move on. But someday you could just do it right up there where you saddle him. I'd just do like a racehorse tie and shoot, I bring up the tarp, I bring up the rope, I bring up the flag, and pretty soon it's just nothing to him. And you get these better broke, kind of more rock solid horses. Now this one's quite a bit different. What I got is just a little old tarp here. And if you notice, I got it kind of folded up pretty tight to start with, because I wouldn't come out just waving it at him, because I want to, like everything else we do, we want to introduce it to him. You know, like when we used to do those clinics, we started at the beginning with those kids, and that's why you had me there, and work on that those riding skills so that pretty soon you could show them how to apply that on the barrels. And man, that foundation is a big deal.
Well, just learning their horses, you know, just
it's everything.
How to make them go and make them click, and how to do it where everything doesn't have to be forceful.
You know what? That should be in red letters. It shouldn't be forceful until they know better, maybe.
Right.
Introduce it to them. If you would be soft and quiet, the result will be soft and quiet. As you're introducing and teaching things, be more patient. Be more patient with your horses. That's a really good point, Charmayne. So I just start a little bit.
But there's
bit
balance
like
to it too, though. There's balance to it.
Boy, I mean, you know, balance is not just physical, just what she's saying. It's mental. It's emotional. There's a balance.
Well, or
in so
letting
many
them
ways.
Get away. As soon as they start getting away and running the show, then you're in trouble.
That's not balance.
That's out of balance.
That's out of balance, yeah. They don't need that. Not forcing anything on this horse. And this one certainly makes a whole different noise. Everything. And everything we're doing, just saying, hey, no matter what comes along, trust me, I won't get you in trouble. But if he needs to flee and use his instinct, well, he can just go right ahead. And I just put him to work and kind of bring him back. Better.
One thing I've noticed even with my farrier is when he tries to trim him or shoe him, most horses you would think would flee from something that scares them, he goes into him, you know, and I've noticed that with me too. Mm-hmm. If I ask him to do something and he has that fight instinct rather than flee.
You know what, that can be a tough horse that does that. And there's more than one that'll do it. So he'll push into it kind of like that's the way he's going to get away from it. That's interesting. So you got to deal with that in a little bit different way. See, I gotta be careful when this comes over in his right eye, that's when he could spook toward me. So I wanna be careful here. I mean, I'm not looking to get run over. Doesn't mean I wouldn't. It wouldn't be the first time. So here.
He looks pretty soft.
He's pretty calm now.
Doesn't look like there's gonna be a problem.
Looks better.
Are you surprised he's being so good for that?
Maybe? I am. Yeah, when he came out with the tarp, I wasn't sure what the reaction would be.
Hey, and by the way, Craig, that's not exactly how I grew up seeing horses being worked with the tarp.
Me either. it was pretty rough back then.
Yeah.
So, boy, it was scary for people and horses, I think. So, but I don't want to force that on this horse. If he's not ready for it, We'll just wait till another time. Don't ask the horse to do anything he's not ready or prepared to do. But that's what we've been doing. We've been preparing him, say, kind of trying to get him ready.
Gonna have to leave work about 30 minutes early every day. You'll be looking at the clock.
I know.
Yeah,
it's all about priorities. And now that I had just worked him in the box and tried to be patient and slow, but it hadn't crossed my mind to do all the groundwork like this. So this is great to kind of go back to the basics.
It'll be, you know, really interesting to watch.
Yeah.
You know, it probably changes your mindset a little bit just watching him go through that, right?
Yeah, for sure.
And so maybe carry over to the arena.
Yeah, it makes me realize too that it's not just an issue of him panicking in the box or being nervous, but rather just his whole mentality about, you know, whoever's hurt him or whatever issues
he
needs to
overcome. And then just him relying on you no matter what, he's safe with you, right?
Right.
When you go somewhere. I think that my horses relied on me a lot to be calm and
their security. Mm-hmm. Kind of, yeah.
Good, big Mike. Good.
That was great.
It's so interesting to me now how he still will take a breath, but he doesn't snort like he did before.
Right. Oh, his face, his eye looks totally different than when he was just even tied up here.
Yeah.
He's like, oh, this is a good day today. Good time to be alive, Craig.
Good.
Right?
I love it. You bet. Yeah. Anytime we do things to help people, and Amy's like a veteran, really great hand, and I love that about a person that's you know, not afraid to say, man, show me what you could do. Because I always enter this pen each and every time as a student of the horse. And I've learned so much from you. I'm willing to learn from you, and we're dang sure willing to learn from this horse.
Well, so, if we just don't, we were all talking about egos. If we can drop our egos and learn from each other, we'd be way further ahead, you know? I can't know everything.
I think
there
the
is to know.
Egoless and prideless, you know, more compassionate you are around these horses, the better results you're
going to
end up with.
And people, right?
And people, that's right.
I mean, what the parents treat their kids, expecting them to do, you know what I mean? And
absolutely.
And then it bleeds over to the horse.
And, you know, these horses, I think they sure enough, they know when you like them and they know when you don't like them. And I think to be good with horses, you got to really, really have a... it's got to come from right there.
They know if you like them or not.
Here, Cole, let's see that ball.
I think just tying them up and leaving them and letting them soak under the saddle.
Oh,
and,
Lordy.
You know, man, I want to saddle them up and get on and go.
I want to be with them, you bet.
Right?
I think there's a lot of truth. You got to spend not just that time, but you got to spend that quality time. Like this is, you see a lot of people use the ball, but... You know, I really take my time with it, and like some spooky horses, I'll leave it in the corral with them. But anything I do or use, I introduce it to them first. You know, our job is to get them ready. Our job is to get them prepared. Prepared for what? Anything we might want to do with these horses. And this is just a way to, gain more confidence, you know, establish some bravery in this horse, and let him figure out we as human beings, you know, these two-legged meat-eating predators, we're not here to kill you or eat you here. We're here to work with you and make a good, brave, nice horse. So there.
He's like, all right.
and it takes time. So the first thing you do is move the ball away from your horse. Move the ball away, because we all know horses, they're like a dog and a cat. They kind of like going after something that moves away from them. So as his foot comes off the ground, I'm going to bump it right into his foot, right, boom, right there. See, he didn't like that too much, but pretty soon he'll figure out that ball will move away from him when he touches it. Good. Good boy. There we go. Good. See, sometimes if you get in a hurry on the back feet, they can kick that thing so hard. So I always start by just kind of rolling it this way. And see how he's really looking at it. And just like you said, he liked those cows, you know, he's kind of like he's interested, but he's cautious. So,
right.
So our job is to be patient, take our time, and let him figure out that, hey, just like everything else we've used, we're not going to hurt you. This is not going to hurt you. And that's what he's always worried about. Here. Yeah. Good boy. Not in a hurry. We'll work that other eye a little bit.
You can see him thinking, trying to figure out what you're asking him to.
It bothers him a little bit. He's like, dang. Jeez.
He's way better than what I could see a lot of horses being. You know.
That's
did you
good.
Slip him some ace, Craig?
Huh?
Did you slip him some ace?
No.
No, good job. He's.
No, it is good. And you know, like anything I can do that'll help a horse to get better, by gosh, that's what I want to do. So, I've seen some guys be real prideful about using something like this, but well, I'm not going to use it. For me, whatever is really going to help my horse and gentle him up and get him more sure and more positive and more brave, well, I'm all for it. So if you present it, what? Just like old Ray Hunt used to say, present it in a way they can understand, then give them the time it takes for them to understand.
What could somebody say about that ball?
Like what?
That would be negative.
Oh, it's just not cool, or it's not cowboy, or it's kind of sissy or something. You know, I've heard all the stuff like that. But for me, man, if it's just going to get my horse better, especially like on a colt or something, never been rode, man, I want every advantage I can to get this horse a little more sure and a little more ready. So if I can, if it'll help, that's what I'm going to do.
You know, if people will think about the way they start them, you'll eliminate a lot of problems down the road with a good start.
I think sometimes the start is, in some ways, the most important day, because that kind of stuff's going to stick
with
him forever, you know. That's going to stick with him forever.
Now, you're going to stand on that ball, right, once you get it up there?
That is what I am not going to do. But I'm letting, see, I don't stop him when he backs up. I wouldn't stop him. If he feels like he needs to back up, we'll let him back up. There you go.
That's a big improvement.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Real and being very responsive, you know.
Real good. Good boy. Good boy. All right. And that's pretty good, laying a pretty good foundation. And just, you know, like they say, sometimes to take two steps forward, you got to take one step back. So just backing up on this old pony and going back to some great foundation work, you know, I think that's a really a smart thing to do, and if you do it right, it can't do anything but help them.
Well put. You look like you know what you're doing.
I'm really excited because after that run at Cheyenne, I was wondering if I was wasting my time or, you know, putting time on a horse that wasn't ever going to be solid. But just the improvement in these few minutes.
Well, at least you know you have things to work on, right?
And, right.
you know, can probably make a difference.
Yeah, but with the progress he's already shown, that excites me about
just what take
his
Craig with you.
Are. Yes,
let him work you before you go rope. Yeah.
Exactly.
Craig, we're going to Cheyenne.
Oh yeah.
Go
I like
hang
old
out.
Cheyenne. Good boy.
Do they break away in Calgary?
Not yet.
Not yet. That's where they need to get it. The Canadians would probably love it.
Yeah. Yeah, I keep seeing it being added more and more, so it's exciting for it.
Yeah, I told Larry D and that I was going to come to school.
Oh, good.
She can teach me a little breakaway.
You should.
It'd be fun.
You know, Nellie Miller's been entering the breakaway.
Has she?
Yeah.
Yeah, good for
her. She ropes good.
Yeah, I bet she does rope good.
All right, Big Mike on the way.
Big Mike?
That's his name.
That's it really
isn't that right?
Yeah.
Big Mike.
I didn't name him either.
I like it when they start getting their heads down, you know, and relaxing. Good boy. I think that's really important that you can get them to drop their heads and really relax.